Today we're going to finish the integral of yz squared dx plus x is z squared dy plus 2xyz dz for this particular curve. So as you can see, it starts off from 2, 0, 0, a straight line to 1, 2, 0, another straight line to 0, 2, 0, and then 0, 2, 0, so x at 0, 2, 2, and finally at 1, 1, 2. Okay, so what we learned from chapter 16.2, that is the fundamental theorem of line integrals, and it says that in order to find a line integral, if it is continuous, and it's conservative, you can use this formula whereby the original integral is equivalent to f of your endpoint minus your f of start point. So basically, you can just ignore all the other curves because it's all continuous, right? And just focus on this one and this one. So your bear in mind that your endpoint is 1, 1, 2, your start point is 2, 0, 0. Okay. So now that we know it's continuous, because the lines are all facing in one path. So what we have to do now is find it's conservative. And in order to do that, you have to find the curl. Okay. So before that, let us take it, take the initial question and put them down to the vector form. It's easier for us to see. Okay. Y is z squared, x is z squared, and 2 x y z. Okay. And this is also just to make it easy for us to see. This is a fx, fy, and fz. Okay. So how do we find it? It's find it in this derivative. Find it f. So the curl of f is the Okay, so we're going to take this part by part. So we're going to start with your fx, which is yz squared.
Okay.
And then we're going to take the antiderivative, and we'll just find x. So that will become the xyz squared. And then if we take an antiderivative, there is always a constant. So this is g in terms of y and z, because we have started with x. So now we're going to find what this is. Basically, we're going to find this. But in order to get that, we have to find it, right? So we are going to take the derivative with respect to y now. So this will become x, z squared, plus g, y, z. Okay, so this is what we found, and this is what we're given. So remember, we're going to compare these two. Okay, so this should equal to x, z squared. And because these are the same, we cancel out, so we can see that gyyz equals to 0. Okay, so we still don't know what this is, right? So what we're trying to find is gyz. So because it's a 0, when you take the antiderivative with respect to y, we're going to see that it's a constant. So this is a constant. So I'm going to rewrite it here. Right. Okay. So f times of x y z equals to x y z squared plus c. Okay. And just to make sure that we are on the right track, we're gonna check back with what we're given here to see if this is what the potential function could be. So we're going to take the potential. So this will become yz squared, this will become xz squared, this will become gxyz. And ta-da, it's the same thing! So this is our potential function, and because it is the same thing, we checked it and we checked it and it's correct. So we can assume that this c does not need to be able to ignore that. So that is our potential function. Now, the last part is that we're going to find the line integral. In order to find a line integral, we have to plug in our endpoints and start point. So the line integral will be your endpoint, which is 1, 1, 2 minus your start point, which is 2, 0, 0. Bear in mind your f is that. So it will be 1, 1, 2, 0, 0. So the answer of 4. Ta-da! So the line integral is 4.